by Michael Rose. And now the Lions on a breakout, sending the shot, and it's in! And an early slap shot, the first shot of the game, just gets by Adam Gost, by Gareth O'Flaherty.
Isn't it?
Given loads of space, and we were worried that the missing D-men today on the...
And number 19, Michael Rose there, just open in front. I mean, there was not a blaze playing full. I mean, I don't know if this is because D was not there at the minute, so they don't know where they need to be.
How about to Larkin? Larkin shoots, and it's in!
Oh, and they've equalised. That is a brilliant goal, coming at a perfect time to keep this match alive.
And congratulations to Jake Larkin on his, I believe, that's his first ever ENL goal. Our announcer Anne, who's a big fan of the under 18 graduates because she's taught most of them, is having
front of the net.
And Jake Larkin, if he'd got a bit more purchase on that shot, could have had his second goal at ENL level. Maynard. It's collected by McFadden. Hubbock dumps it down as Whiteman comes in, but now there's a fight between Larkin and Quinn. Pollock now gives it back to Hubbock. Hubbock sends the shot in and scores!
And that was a beautiful pass there, straight tape to tape, and he put it top corner. You saw the water bottle lift.
You saw the water bottle lift. Connor Hubbock has been on a scoring streak as of late. He scored one last week, one the week before that. I believe one the week before that.
Indeed, and you was asking, would he score again tonight? Is it an earlier chance? And yes he would.
And it's now 2-1 to the ENL Blaze. But again, the Lions committing the sin of not having a player on somebody in the middle of those hash marks. It's the same mistake Whitley made last week twice. Bryniarski to Stevenson. Stevenson now, just the pace and speed he has. Stevenson, though, closed down again in front of the net. But now Josh Nicklin. Nicklin shoots. And Griffiths managed to just send the puck wide. And another hard attempted hit by Chris Brown.
Yeah, Nicklin once again came away with it.
Puck is loose. It's still live. We haven't heard a whistle.
It's in the crease. I'm not sure who's on top of it.
Well, we can see James Robinson on top of Rikki Bryniarski. Get his number later, Rikki. So, James Pease plays it to Rikki Bryniarski. He's got Stevenson waiting in the middle. Bryniarski, though, tries to stick handle his way through as he's harassed. Stevenson. Pease. James Pease winds up and it takes a deflection. Bryniarski has it on the doorstep, and there we have another goal on the doorstep for the ENL Blaze.
Indeed, it's really good skill there by Rikki. He just felt the puck hit him and waited for it to drop between his legs.
Well, that was all started though at the point by James Pease with a big slap shot that came in, took a deflection off the very well organised but heavy screen in front of Griffith. Griffith couldn't see where it was, and Bryniarski had it on the doorstep, one on one. And at that range, he's not going to miss. Well, Chris, if you look at the way the Blaze have been playing for the last few minutes, I think they've worked out. Griffith gives rebound, play close, you'll get goals. Now, as Danny Rose is released, Rose with the puck sends the puck in across, and it's gone in. Chaos in front of the Blaze net, and either Brown or Rose is going to take credit for that.
Indeed, and if either of them missed it, it would have been Quinn at the back door. He was steaming in towards there.
Blaze defense leaving Adam Goss a little bit out and exposed.
That aggression from Goss is really helpful, attacking the puck like that in this situation. The last thing you want from your goalie is attacking the puck when you've got four or five Nottingham players around you now. Gareth Owen sends it in, and it's in!
That's another goal up high. We said he doesn't like to be using his glove and blocker too much, and that's twice at least the Blaze have scored up high.
Well, Gareth Owen was released again, a Blaze player on his own. Might as well have been a power play because the Lions seem to be a man down on the defence, and Gareth Owen gets a beautiful opportunity to, as you said, send it high because Griffiths just doesn't seem to want to use his glove hand.
Once again, we've seen that water bottle pop off, and who knows, they may even be targeting it as a little points tally system between themselves.
I know whenever I shot, I used to aim for the water bottle if I could see it. To be honest, if you can see it and you're a forward, that's probably a sign that the goalie's not covering his angles quite well. So, Robinson sends it in. James Pease. Pease still with it, gives it to Bryniarski. Bryniarski to Stevenson. Stevenson's got Nicklin waiting for it out on the wing. And an
and a call for a slashing. The play's complete, and now James Pease goes after and falls over himself, goes after Ben Woods.
Indeed, I've not seen Pease really this wired up before, but he really is not happy.
And I really wish we had a replay of another camera somewhere in the rink to see what was going on here, because I'm guessing Wood did something to Pease, Pease didn't appreciate it, Pease slashed him.
Yeah, Pease is not a player that I'd want to really mess with. He's a big lad.
And so we have the first power play of the game, and it goes to the Nottingham Lions. And it will be 2 minutes for slashing to James Pease. Oh, it's going to be cross-checking. I apologise. He's been given 4 minutes.
Indeed, a 2+2. He did go after the Ben Wood from the Nottingham Lions after the whistle had been...
Rikki Bryniarski waving his stick around. And he takes down Ben Wood. Lions line looking very tired. They're looking for a chance to go for a fresh change here. And a pane of plexiglass has come loose. And I'm not sure how that happened. The glass didn't even break, amazingly. But we're going to take a little break while rink maintenance sort out the glass. Okay, we're back from the ad break. It turns out that the glass was broken by Nick Wyatt trying to lay a not very hard hit on Kieran Papps. But interesting now. The face-off is going to take place over here.
Selby.
As James Pease flattens Michael Rose at centre ice. Now, Connor Hubbock. Still with it, waiting for the blue line support to come in. Hubbock now still with it. Hubbock sends it in and scores! And that's two goals for Connor Hubbock. Connor Hubbock is on a streak, ladies and gentlemen, a hot streak. That's a hot stick, because that is, I believe, his sixth goal in 3 weeks. Ledgards can't get on the end of that stretch pass, and Kemp will dump it back in. Pound to Stevenson. Stevenson now going it alone. Stevenson attempts for the wraparound. It was loose in front of the net. Griffiths is down inside the net. And he's not moving. And Stevenson was shoved in to the net. And Griffiths is getting up very slowly. And I don't believe Dean Goodwin's going to... Goodwin has called a penalty. And it will be against number 5, Johnny Bell. I would assume that would be for the shove that resulted in. Oh no, it's 2 minutes for slashing.
A win is always good, but a win over Nottingham must feel pretty sweet.
Yeah, it feels good. Going into the game, we were down a few guys, but everyone stepped up. We haven't won in a while, and it was just good. We just stuck to our game plan. We played for 60 minutes tonight, which was the key thing. I mean, the last few games we've only played for 40 minutes. Like last week we played Whitley. We were good until the third period, and we just sort of went off our game plan, allowed them back in the game, and they ended up winning. So this week it was just good. We all stuck to our game plan. Every line chipped in, which was good. The third line were awesome tonight, so they really stepped up for us, which is good.
Yep, third line really did chip in a lot of points this evening, but you got yourself a goal. You've got a pretty hot stick at the moment, really, haven't you? I mean, what's the secret with you, Josh and Mikey, at the moment?
I think we're all just sort of, we're just used to each other, know each other. When we're on the ice, we all know sort of where we're going to be. We all talk on the ice. We just know, like I said, where we're going to be. It's just great. I mean, we're all sort of different players. Like Josh is the fast guy on the line. Mikey's the skilled guy, and I'm just supporting those two guys. And at the moment, the goals just seem to be going in, which is good. I mean, I'm just playing my normal game, but this year they just seem to be going in, which is nice.
Well, thank you very much, Rikki. Okay.
Okay, so how do you want me to phrase the question?
Okay, Reg. 2 points. Must feel pretty sweet, but must feel even sweeter considering it's against Nottingham.
Yeah, it's 2 points, 4 points, really. Puts us above them in the league now. Obviously, played Nottingham quite a few times over the years, including the playoffs last year when we came away beating them at their own rink to go through. I thought tonight was a great game. Great game.
As I recall it in past history, the best result your boys have ever managed here at the Dome has been a draw against them. So, I mean, what was different tonight about the performance today as opposed to every other performance they've put in against Nottingham here?
The difference, I think, today was everybody skated really hard. Everybody stuck to the game plan a little bit that we wanted to do, particularly in the third period. We actually stuck to the plan. We didn't go off doing different things, trying to be heroes at the wrong time. And I think that's really what I'm most pleased about tonight, is the way we actually closed out the game in the third.
You did mention to us a few weeks ago off camera that second period slumps were a bit of a curse for this team at the moment, but they definitely did step it up today and played a full 60 minutes, full three period hockey. And it was good to see as well the under 18 graduates like Jake Clarkin getting his first goal today and putting in some big shifts.
Yeah, we've certainly sorted out the second period stuff, so I'm not going to dwell on that. But yeah, Jake had a great game tonight. I mean, he took his goal really, really well. He took his time. He made a deke, he got it on his backhand, he put it in the net. You know, he couldn't ask any more for the kid. But it wasn't just that, the rest of his game was really good. He forechecked really well once he got going. He had a little bit of a slow start, but then he kind of got into his stride, and it was really good to see. I was really pleased with him tonight.
Thank you very much, Reg.